Hello everyone, welcome to this webinar. So our today's session is about demystifying permissions, unveiling the basics and applications in Navision 2018. So before I actually move into the webinar, I would like to introduce myself. My name is Rashmi Sharma and I am a Microsoft certified trainer. I have been working as a Business Central functional consultant. And also I have been in learning and development profile for quite some time now. That is about me. And before that, I was working as an analyst in an MNC, in a multinational company. Okay, so that is brief information about me. I would like you guys also to give a brief introduction about yourselves, your profile and your work experience in the chat. All right, so I'm guessing I have a diverse audience over here. No problem. And that is how I have decided to present this particular session to you. Let's start with the session now. Now, this is going to be the webinar agenda, in which I'll be introducing you to the Navision 2018 first. Then I'll be taking you through how you can create new users and user groups and how you can actually link your permissions and permission sets to users. We are also going to see how easily you can create permission sets and link it to users. What are the different ways Navision as a platform provides us in order to link those users and permissions in an easy manner? And then we are also going to look into some peripheral areas of security on Navision. That is going to be our webinar agenda for today. Now, as I'm seeing, we have people who might be new to Navision, and there might be people who are well-versed on the platform, who have worked on Navision. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to first introduce Navision to you as a platform. What is Navision? Navision is an ERP platform. Basically, it's an enterprise resource planning platform. And when I say enterprise resource planning, that means anything an organization does inside it can be done on Navision. If you're using it in your organization, anything you are doing in your organization can be done on Navision. Now, when I say anything, that means it includes all kinds of operations, human resources, supply chain management, your entire finance can be handled by Navision. This as a platform, it started in 1983, and then it was renamed as Navigator. As you can see in the slide, it was called 1987. In 1987, it was called Navigator. Then it was renamed as Navision in 89. And throughout the years, it has changed a lot. It has gained some features. It has lost some features. It has deprecated some features according to the feedback that it receives from different diverse clients who are using this particular platform. So the major change that happened in the Navision's journey was when Microsoft acquired it in 2002, to be precise. Microsoft acquired this Navision platform, and again, the development on the platform continued. The most recent development on the platform, about the platform, is that now it is called as Business Central. In 2018, this major change happened, and now we have further developments that are happening on the platform by the name Business Central. As Navision, we are going to talk about Navision version 2018. So I'm going to focus on that, okay? So when we talk about Navision, first of all, it is also known as Nav among users. So people who are, you know, using it quite often, so they just in short call it as Nav. So don't get confused. Nav is just Navision. And it is basically helping any kind of business to actually organize itself on a centralized platform. Now, Navision as a platform, it's a multi-currency and a multi-language platform. You can use it in different languages. You can utilize different currencies on it so that your finance is easily managed. And also, it is going to make your work a lot more easy as compared to if you do not have such a centralized system. As you can see on the slide, more than 1 lakh companies, they are currently using Navision. So there might be a reason for that, right? So more than 1 lakh organizations, they are actually using Navision as a platform, as an ERP platform. The question automatically arises, why such a thing is there? Why Navision is getting used so much? Because as we know that there are different competitors of Navision in market, right? But still Navision is most widely used. So the next question that comes up is, why is Navision more successful in market? The first thing is that it caters to small and medium-sized businesses both. It is not restricted to small organizations. It can easily handle up to mid-sized companies, businesses, organizations, legal entities, whatever you want to call. Any kind of process that we are doing, be it operations, be it finance, supply chain, analytics, commerce, anything Navision can handle, right? One thing is that it can handle everything. Second is it is very flexible. It is very capable of adapting to the changes, to the needs that customers have. You have a basic platform of Navision, but then you can also customize it according to your own needs. Now, it also allows customization and integrations per requirement, as you can see. So whenever a customer asks you for the platform, you can provide the basic platform to the client, but clients can be of different you can say areas. It can be a food-based industry. It can be a electronics industry. It can be a electricals-based industry. It can be a clothing line industry. If you are the person who is implementing Navision for your customer, you can actually ask your customer, okay, what are your needs? Then you are going to perform a fit gap analysis. If whatever needs of your customers, if they are more than what Navision already provides, of course you are going to customize it for him. But then if I talk about implementation, the implementation of Navision is very, I would say, it's pretty fast as compared to other platforms. It can be implemented within a week. Some customizations might take time according to your needs, according to your customer's needs, but basic platform can be implemented within a week. That is one more advantage for you. Like, I know that many platforms, they might even take 3 months to get implemented, but here we are talking about a week, which is pretty, pretty fast as compared to other platforms. Other than that, we also have a basic advantage added to the Navision because it's a Microsoft product that you can actually integrate Navision with other Microsoft CRM applications. What is CRM application? Simply customer relation management. It is also known as customer engagement applications, where we actually introduce our products to our customers, where we are dealing with the customers. So those applications also can be successfully integrated with Navision. Now, question arises, why would I want to do that? I mean, I have Navision. I am still integrating it with other applications. Why? Navision has basic CRM capabilities, but if I want to go and do full-blown CRM activity, the complete process, then I require additional CRM applications for that. And because all of these are Microsoft products, they can be seamlessly integrated with one another. That is also one advantage. So just imagine I have some customer data in my CRM application and I can just easily utilize it in my Navision platform. I can actually lure my customers towards my products and I can, you know, analyze how my customer is behaving, how I can actually provide him more maybe loyalty points, reward points. Somehow I want to make him permanent in my business. So that kind of data is going to help me a lot in order to make my business achieve more profits, right? Okay. Now, having said that, we know that Navision is more successful, but there are other reasons also other than this. What are those reasons? Why it is good for your business, for any kinds of business that we have? First thing is, we'll simplify your business. And when I say simplify, I am talking about a central system, an integrated system where all my departments, like for example, I have my finance, F&M manufacturing, supply chain, sales, marketing, any department that is there with me, I can just put it on a centralized system of Navision. And I am sure that none of my department now is working in silos. Now everything is integrated with each other, right? All of my data can be, it can seamlessly transition from one part, from one department to another. There is no gap in between now. Everybody is using the same application, right? Second advantage of that is that it is going to improve my productivity. Improving productivity, why? We are talking about a Microsoft product. So it is very obvious how it is going to improve my efficiency. Because if you have seen, I don't know how many of you have actually worked on Navision, how much you have worked, but yes, those who have worked actually agree with me that whenever you open any kind of page in Navision, for example, you're opening a customer's list page or you're opening a vendor's list page, just an example, what happens is the look and the feel of the page is very, very similar to what you have seen throughout your childhood days, like you have been using Microsoft Excel, right? The upper part sort of feels like ribbon. Then the lower part, you have a rose and your columns. So that is also very, very intuitive in nature. You tend to understand the page much more faster as compared to other ERP applications that we have out in the market. And I have seen them. They are not that intuitive in nature, the other applications. So that is one major advantage that we have in Microsoft products right now, which is Navision, which we are talking about, which means my productivity is going to increase, right? When I'm able to understand applications very fast, of course, my work activity, my efficiency is going to increase on the particular application. Third that we have is it is implemented rapidly, that we have already talked about. It's not very, it does not take very long time to get implemented. Plus, after it gets implemented, it has lots and lots of tools which help us to analyze our data and help us to make our informed decisions. It has lots of reporting tools which are just one click away. You click on the report and the report is ready for you based on the data that you have on the platform. So that is also going to help me a lot when I'm actually working on large amount of data, right? And the last that we have is that I can quickly set up and customize my system to meet my current business needs. I'm going to make smart decisions, right? Because it's easy to adapt. The functionality, whatever are there, they're very easy to, they're adaptable according to your needs. And I'm going to make smart decisions based on the data that I have on the platform. Now, there are so many advantages with Dynamics that we have just started with the Navision. Now, let's see what actually we can do on the platform, what modules I have on the platform. If you see here, I have so many capabilities with Navision, be it manufacturing, which includes maintaining of orders along with deliveries and updating my users with the real-time data. Then finance is there, which is about managing your accounts and assets and currencies. Sales and marketing, which includes data related to customers. When I'm talking to my customers, when am I trying to lure my customers towards my business? How am I going to do that? Supply chain management, it is all about how you are going to deal with your products. How the product is going to come in to you in your warehouse. How products are going to go out from your warehouse to your customers. How you're going to deliver your products. What should be the site? What should be the warehouse? Where should be kept everything. Then we have service management. Service management is all about customer inquiries, creating tickets, orders, and generating reports. Now, other than that, you might have heard like many organizations, they work on project basis. So for that, we have project management. Project management, it involves everything related to a project that you create when you deal with your client. I am sitting in my organization. Let's say I get a project. How am I going to plan for that project? I'm going to ask my resources, my employees for that particular project. I'm going to allocate them some work according to the skills that they have. I'm also going to see what should be the billing. When should be the billing? Should be when I should bill my customers. It should be interim, it should be quarterly, or should be yearly billing. Like some projects, they are quite huge. Not all projects are small that you have to bill them at once only. No. If a project is, for example, for a year, I am not going to pay them after the after an entire year. I'm going to pay them quarterly and monthly on some kind of deal I'm going to make with the customer, and I'm going to pay them. So all of that, how I'm going to track different reports, different WIPs that I'm going to make, work in progress reports, I'm going to share with my customer and everything. So all of that management, what should be the budget of a particular project, entire project cycle can be maintained on Navision. Other than that, I can also provide some data insights. On the platform, real-time data can also be provided. These are something which like one or the other employees is going to do. Then comes your human resource management, which is entirely your HR department, how they are going to use this Navision platform. When I said on Navision, you can do everything, that means everything. See, human resource even is coming into picture. They are also going to use the same platform. And they are going to use, for example, let's say an employee comes in into the organization, right from maintaining their payments and seeing what projects they are doing, what kind of attendance they have, as in how they are taking leaves, when they are paid, everything can be maintained on Navision through human resource management module. And lastly, there is warehouse management, which involves your inventory management, which involves how items are going to be stored in your warehouses, in your sites, in your shelves, in your bins. So what we do in warehouse management is we try to get more granular details of where I'm storing a particular item, from where I'm picking a particular item, from where I'm sending an item, from where I'm receiving an item in a warehouse. All of that can be managed in the Navision platform. So if I want to see pictorially, if I want you to show you how and what all Navision can handle, these are the modules that we have on Navision. Now, okay, before I move into permissions, there is one thing that comes up in anybody's mind who is working on Navision. We have so many modules, we have so many, I would say, capabilities of Navision, and not everybody is going to do everything. It has to be role-based, there has to be some restriction. I, as an administrator, cannot allow everybody to do everything on platform, because I do not want to mess my data. I do not want to lose the integrity of the platform, and whatever maybe reports, whatever maybe list of customers, list of vendors, I would not want anybody to just go into the platform and delete a customer or delete a vendor, which will create a havoc for me, right? So in order to stop all of that, I have something called permissions. Permissions, now, what are permissions? If you think about permissions in like real life scenarios, what is a permission? Permission means I'm asking somebody maybe to do a particular kind of work. I want to maybe I want to go out. I am taking somebody's permission. I am in my office. I'm taking my boss's permission to do something. Similarly, on platform, you have your permissions and permission sets. I, as a user, should not be able to do everything in the simple language. So you can define permissions as the areas of the system of the platform which a user can edit and access. And when I talk about editing, I'm talking about modifying, deleting, or adding something, which can create problems if everybody is allowed to do anything on the platform. So we have permissions for that to restrict that particular access. And the group of permissions, as you know, it will make your permission set. So if I just show you something over here. So in easy language, what we can say, we have permissions and we have permission sets. We have users and we have user groups. Now, for me to assign permission to anybody, I first need to have users on my platform. So what I can do here on the platform, I can assign permission to users, or I can assign permissions to user groups. So in simple language, you can call permission sets as group of permissions and user groups as set of people, set of users accessing the platform. So it totally depends upon, as an admin, on the administrator, that what he wants to do, how he wants to grant these permissions. Let's go back. All right. Now, there's a good news over here for Navision 2018. Before Navision 2018, this permission sets and granting permissions was a huge and complex topic for everybody who was using Navision. It was very complex, as in you need to have your developers and your partners to actually go about and decide about what permissions you need, what permissions, how to grant permissions, and all of that process. But with Navision 2018, it has become really, really easy. And the interface for granting the permission and the pages that you need on the platform, that has also become very easy to do. And that I will show you on the demo itself. Now, in Navision 2018, all users, they must be assigned one or more permission set if they want to access platform. Okay. Now, when we talk about permissions and permission sets, there are certain standard rules. Now, I have a list of permissions in my system. I have some basic permission sets also, where I'm just telling the user that you can log in into the system, bare minimum permissions I'm giving to you. Okay, I can do that, or I can create some functional role-based permission sets also. For example, I am providing you a permission of just creating purchase orders because you belong to accounts payable maybe, or I'm asking you just to post them, or I'm asking you just to create a sales order. So if I want to give certain kinds of roles to such people, I can create such permission sets and assign them those permissions. And these users who are having these permission sets only, they will be able to do that kind of work only, nothing else. I have two things. On one level, I have all the power as an admin to restrict the permissions. And also I have power to give the broadest permission possible, which basically is known as a super permission. Super permission basically means you can access each and everything on the platform. But then you might be confused with super data also. You have something called super data on the platform also. Super data, if you compare super and super data, super is about you can administer users, you can design and change objects, you can run tables from the designer. But when you talk about super data, that means you still have the full access of the application, but you cannot perform the above three functions. So basically, if any person wants to, you know, for example, I want to run all the reports anywhere in the system, but I do not want to edit anything, or I as an admin, I'm giving rights to a permission to a particular user, and I do not want that person to actually edit anything, just run all the reports. For that kind of permission, I can create also a new permission set with, for example, a name. I can give to that permission set. I can call it as a super read. And accordingly, I can assign the permissions to that particular user. Having super means having access to all. So it's very clear from the name itself. Okay, the user is having access to all complete application, but only the read permission inside that. So that can also be done. Now we know what is a permission set, what are permissions, what is a permission set, and we know what are users and user groups. Now the second question that comes into picture is, how am I going to grant permissions to my users? In my platform in Navision 2018, we have a process of creating users, which is pretty much simple. You just have to go to a particular page called users, and you have to click the new button, and your users will be created. Now, it depends on you as an admin, whether you want to create a user group or you want to go user by user when you are granting permissions. So either it can be a single user or it can be a user group itself. And we will see how we can actually link this user to the user group. Now, this slide basically explains you what actually is going to happen. Let me just show you the entire slide. Okay. Now, you add users onto the platform. You add those users to user group. And I as an admin is going to assign permission set on this particular user group. And all the users which are inside the user group, they are going to inherit those permissions. As in, they will be allowed to do those functions which are there allocated with this particular user group. Now, when we create a permission set, what else we can do? We can copy a permission set. We can include or exclude a permission set from a user. Then we can also import permissions. We can allow or disallow permissions. We can add permissions to related tables. And we can do many more things with the permissions that we are going to see. Importing and exporting of permissions is needed. Like, for example, I have my permission set ready for me. I have another user. I would not want that user to do all the things again. Setting up all the permission sets again. What I will do, I'll export my file as an XML file, and that user is going to import that file, and he will get all the permission sets with him, whatever I have also created. It's just about that. When we talk about granting permissions, I can grant permission on table data, table, reports, code units, and many more object types. Depending upon what kind of permission you are granting, any kind of object type can be selected. And in that, what kind of permission I'm giving? Am I giving a read permission? Insert permission where I'm able to modify my data also. Let's say I'm creating a customer card. Am I able to change the data in that particular card? Or am I able to delete a customer detail onto the platform? That is a delete permission. Or am I able to run a particular report which comes under the execute permission part? That is, execute is mainly related to running forms and reports. I have all these different types of permissions that I have on the platform. Inside read, insert, modify, delete, execute also, I have different sorts of permission that I give. Either I can take away the permission from the user, which will be my blank option, which is basically standing for no, or I can give the read permission. That means I'm giving the yes permission over here. Inside read, I'm saying take the permission as in yes. Or I can give an indirect permission also. Indirect means you have your, let's say I'm giving an indirect permission on GL accounts. I can post onto the GL accounts. But if I actually go on to chart of accounts, I'll not be able to see the amount over there. I'll not be able to click over it. That is a kind of indirect permission I'm giving. I do not need permission on the entire chart of account as such. Just I'll be able to post it from a different posting setup. That is a kind of indirect permission I can give to users. Where I'm actually restricting some work, I'm actually allowing some work on a particular kind of table. So that is also a lot more time needed than rather to give the entire permission as yes. Other than these that we have just discussed, we also have record level security. So record level security is even more stringent. When I say record level, I'm talking about example. a particular customer, a particular vendor, or a particular item. That is a record. So when I say I'm giving a record level security, I'm talking about my security filter over here. So other than read, insert, modify, delete, execute, I also have a security filter over here. So security filter means if I am selecting, if you can see in the slide, I have my item selected, and under item, under security filter, I am giving base unit of measure is box. That means whoever user gets this permission set, he will be able to see items, access items only when the base unit of measure is box. And once it is granted to a user, this will be applicable to the list page as well as the reports. When the user will run the reports for the item, he will be able to see only such items where the base unit of measure is box. That is about the item table. If you want to know a better, simpler example, we can also think about, we have our customers. We have salespersons who are associated with these customers, who will be dealing with these customers, who will be selling some items to these customers. Now, I can restrict that only customers where salesperson code is JR in this example, only those customers a person should be able to access. Maybe because that user is related only to these kinds of customers. I do not want him to go into any other customer where salesperson is not JR. So that is a kind of record level security I can set up on the platform. And it is pretty useful in restricting people from what they actually access on a particular page and what they can't. All right. Okay, we have started what different kinds of permissions we have, how we can set them up. Why do I need permission sets? Of course, to reduce my error. Why the sets? Because I want to reduce my error. I, as an admin, I do not want to give each and every single permission to each and every user. I will create groups of permission. I will create groups of users, and I can link permission sets to those user groups in one go. And all of this I'm doing just because I want to enhance my security on my platform. Again, repeating the same, reiterating the same, that I do not want people to be actually accessing each and every part of the platform. Just the ones that they actually need should be granted to them. Rest of the platform should be hidden. A simplest example of that would be, for example, I would not like everyone to see everyone's payslip, maybe, right? So that is where your permission sets comes into picture. And I think you guys might have seen in your organization also, when you try to access the organization portal, some pages, they show you are not allowed access to this page. That is where these permission sets are actually working on. Because your admin actually has denied that this set of people should not be allowed access. The reason is simple, because you do not need it. And we do not want you to change anything on that particular page. As simple as that. Next that we have is how we can grant these permissions easily to users. As we have discussed, we have users group page. We have something called recording permissions also that we are going to see. Okay, before moving further into the slides, I would like you to show the demo now of whatever we have just covered, and then I'll come back to the slide itself. Just give me a moment. All right. So this is how your platform looks like, Navision platform. And this page itself is known as a role center page. Right now, I'm logged in as business manager. My profile is business manager. And if you want to see how you can change this profile, you can go into my settings. And in this pop-up, you can see my role center is business manager. If I go into the lookup table from here, I have all the available roles over here. I can just click on a particular role, click on OK, exit the application, and my role will be changed. Similarly, I can change my legal entity also from here. All right. So this role center page actually is about what profile you have in your organization and how Navision is going to make it easy for you to actually navigate onto the platform. As a business manager, I need this kind of look on the platform. If I change my profile, some things will be changing here and there, and it totally depends upon what kind of work I'm doing on the organization. Role center will just come into after I'll show you the demo for permission set. Now, let's leave behind role center a little bit. We know that this is role center page, right? Now, let's go and see where my permission sets are onto the platform. So let's go and see permission sets. This is a list of permission sets that I have. You can see the entire list, the code and the name for it. For example, I have global dimension management permission set. Who can change that? I have accounts payable related, journals related, receivables related, everything I have over here. If I want to see which particular permissions are there in the permission set, then I'm going to just click on a particular permission set and I'll click on permissions over here. And I can see inside this permission set, which is accounts payable D365, this permission set, I have these many permissions over here on these tables. Under that, first of all, I have my object ID, corresponding object name. Then I have read, insert, modify, delete, execute permissions, which we discussed. If you see the dropdown, I have three options. Blank means there's no permission for reading. Then we have yes permission, and then we have indirect permission. Other than these four, we have a security filter over here. So let's say I'm into this particular table, vendor, and inside the security filter, I can go into my lookup table over here, and I can mention over here which field I want to put the filter onto. Let's say I'm putting filter on the vendors table, but I'm saying that you can access only those vendors where, where purchaser code is AR, if that is a purchaser in your system. And I will click on OK. And I have my security filter right set on to the system. Now it becomes more restricted. Okay, once I'm done with this kind of editing, I'll just click on OK. So you just realize that the permission sets that are already available on the platform, I'm able to even edit that. That is one thing that we have on Navision 2018. It's not restricting me to do that. But if I do not want to do that, if I do not want to change the already available permission sets, I can also create a copy of a permission set. So I will just click on a particular permission set. And under actions, I have copy permission set option available. I'll just click on copy. And I'll provide a new name, receivables name. Okay. And click on OK. I have my new permission set ready. Go under Home tab. These are known as tabs. Okay. So under this permission set, which I've just created, if I want to see what all permissions are there, though you can see here also, but if I want to see it in proper table format, I can just click on permissions over here and I can see all the permissions here, right here. Okay, I've just copied a permission set into another by giving a new name. And now, because I did not want to edit my original one, I can edit whatever I want over here. Any permission manually, yes, no, whatever you want to give, indirect. That is about copying a permission. Now, we have seen a list of permissions and what all permissions are there on the in the permission set. But in order for me to do that, to assign permissions to users, I need to have users first, right? That is the first and foremost thing that I need to have. So for that, what I will do, I will just go into my users page. Now that is the first thing that I showed you on the slide also. You need to add users first. How am I going to add users? Right now, I have Rashmi1, Administrator, Sharma, Rashmi, and Demo14, these many users over here. If I want to add one more user, I'll just click on New button, and my user card opens up. I can provide a name over here. Let's say it's a Jim, and I can provide a full name. Jim Corbett. So I have a username, I have a full name, and my user card is ready. So inside user group tab, I have nothing right now. And inside user permission sets also, I do not have anything. I have just created a user right now. I'll just click on OK. And see, I have user here, which is enabled. And One more thing, people who are new to Navision, for whom the navigation on the platform is not that fluent, I would say. See, when I click on a particular user, in the fact box, I can see the information changing. If I click on Rashmi, I have permission sets available over here, which is applicable for this user. And I can also see which user group membership this particular person has. If I click on Gym now, which I just created, nothing is there because I have not added anything till now, right? What if I want to add this particular user to a group? Okay, before even doing that, I have my single user right now. As an admin, I can just go into permission set by user. And that is the way by which you can easily grant your permissions. You have this matrix page for you. You have all the permissions over here in the Y-axis. And here in the X-axis, you can see all the users. I have, if you just broaden this one, you can see it clearly. I have Rashmi 1, Sharma, Rashmi, all my users are there. And I have a separate column of all users as well. If I have too many users, I can just click on all users button like this. And this particular permission is granted to all users in one single click. Click it back to remove. See, and click it back and it will get removed. Okay, and if I want to grant user by user basis, that also is doable. Just click on the box below the user and just right after the permission and your permission will be granted. I just created Jim as a user. And just write in this one. If I want to assign him this cost account in view permission set, I'll just come up here and click on this button. Now Jim has this particular permission set. That's it. Okay. And one more thing, if you have too many users right here, you won't be able to see everything. You have these options for you right here. If I click on all columns, right, I'll be able to see everything over here. Okay. It's just about the view of the page. Okay. Click on OK. And now if you see Jim, Jim has this particular permission set over here. See, Jim is still not a part of any user group. How do I change this? How do I make him a part of a group so that he does not feel alone? So what I will do, I will create a user group. So either I can just go from here, user groups, and I can also go from the search option. So let's just go from here. Go to user group, and I have a list of user groups available to me where I have different codes, the name for it, and the default profile that they will be using when they are going to enter into the platform. So let me create a user group. Let's say it's a accountant. Okay. And I'll give it a name. And the default profile that I want such a group to have is, let's say, accounting manager. Okay, that's it. My work here is done. The new user group has formed, accountant new. And if you see, nothing is there right now in it, right? No permission set and no members. I'll just, now, there are two things. Either I can grow from here, user group by user. So let's see what's there in it. Now, this is again your matrix page. What I can do, all the users are here and all the user groups are here. If I want to assign user to a user group, I can do it from here also. Just example, Jim has to be a part of, let's say, finance. So I just put a tick mark over here. Okay, let me just click here to see what I made. So, sales manager, accountants. Yeah, here it is, accountant's name. This is the one that I just created. I want him to part of this group also. Clicked on both and click on OK. Now accountant new, see the details, Jim is a part of it. Yet this group does not have any permission set till now. So if I want to assign permission set on this group now, because I know Jim is already a member of it, so I don't need to work with Jim now. I will work with my group itself. So what I can do, I can go into my permission set by user group. I'll just click here. And now see how easy it is for me to do. I have all my permission sets over here and all my groups over here. And don't panic if you don't have all your groups. It's just a one click away. Just have to click on all columns right and you will be able to see everything. Okay. Now I have my permission sets here. I have my groups over here. Again, I can just put a tick mark and provide permissions just like that. Okay. And that's it. You have your permissions ready. You can provide it to all users, right? And the ones which are a little bit, you can say, critical in nature, you will get this particular pop-up. Do you really want to add this permission set to all user group? I'll say yes. Okay. So click on OK, and your permission groups will be granted to a particular user group. Now see this one. I have accountant new. I have these permission sets for this particular group, and I have this member, Jim, over here. Okay. That is how you can manually assign your permissions. Okay. Now, of course, the question that comes up in our mind is, do I really have to do this way only? Is there any other way that I can grant permissions to users? There is, which is a more automatic way of doing it. So for that, I will go into permission sets page again. And let's say, let's create a new permission set. By the name record permission set. Now, with the name only, you must have guessed what I'm about to do right now. Now, in this permission set right now, which I just created, if you view the permissions, nothing is there. It is totally blank slate. If I want to add permissions here a little bit in a faster way, what I can do, I can go under actions and you see the start button over here. I can just click on start. What I'm trying to do is I'm trying to record a process here. I do not want to grant. I do not want to add permissions here table by table, one by one manually. I want to record my process and my work will be done. So what I will do, I will just click on the start button over here and the pop-up comes up. Do you really want, do you want to start the recording now? I'll say yes. Once my recording starts over here, okay, I'll just minimize this one and this one. Now, let's say I want to add vendors, okay? So I'll just go on to vendors. This is my vendors list page. I'm trying to create a new vendor, okay? So I'll click on new, choose a template out of here, say, okay, vendor domestic, and I'll provide a name. Let it be Microsoft. And that's it, okay. Once my process is done, I'll go on back into my edit permissions page. And you can see I have a stop button over here, which is active now. I can just click on stop button. And do you want to add? I'll say yes. And see what happened. I have got all my related tables over here, which was related to the process that I just performed. I do not need to find all the related tables, because on a particular table, you will have multiple fields. Those multiple fields are also coming from various tables on the platform. So automatically my system is going to give me related tables over here. And I've been given this read, write, insert, whatever permissions I need on that particular, according to the process that I have just performed. And if you are okay with this particular permissions that are coming up, you can just click on okay. Or again, you can just go, still you can manually edit them. That there is no restriction over here. Again, I can manually edit, but my work here is reduced. That is the whole point of recording the permissions. And it is used hugely in organizations. It's a really, really useful feature on Navision. I'll just click on OK. And not every platform has this. So it's really, really useful feature here. And that is how you can record your permissions. Now, let's go on to my PPT once and so we have covered this, right? Okay, so I have given you a broad understanding of what permissions are, the basics, and how we can grant it to users, how we can record a permission. That is, permission is a permission sets and permissions, they are a part of security on the platform. We all know that. We have discussed it enough. Beside permissions, we also have other things on the platform for us to actually restrict people from going here and there and doing anything that they want. First thing that I want to discuss is that there is common misconception among people that role center is a part of security. It's not. Role center is not a part of your security. Role center page that I showed you is just a way of giving you an access according to your profile and how you can actually improve the usability of the platform. Role center is just about that. When you actually want to give access to various pages on the platform, you have to go and set your permissions and permission sets. It's not like you will change the role and your permissions will work on that. No, you have to grant you. That's the first and foremost thing that you need to do when you actually implement Navision for any of your customers. That has to be done. When we are doing such an activity, when we are implementing our platform for our customers, we need to keep in mind few things. Let's say I'm designing a role. So I should actually focus on smaller tasks. For example, creating a PO, posting a PO, maybe releasing a sales order. Very smaller tasks, not the entire purchase to pay cycle, for example, because purchase to pay cycle has lots of things. If I create one big role just like that, I will not be able to actually test what kind of permissions I'm talking about for a particular user. So the best practice is assign small tasks to different users and accordingly assign them permissions. And similarly, we should not make roles for each and every user. It should be obviously group-based, because otherwise it's very hard to debug what is going wrong anywhere. If some user comes to you, I do not have permission for a particular table, and to actually know what is actually happening on the platform, it's really, really difficult to debug which permission set got missing, which is unnecessarily given to the user, and it's really, really hard. So we should always try to make our roles a little bit on the group basis, and also the tasks that you are providing to the users, they should be small tasks, not very wide tasks should not be provided. That is one of the, that there are the, these are the two best practices that we have for the Navision platform when we are designing the roles. Other than that, we have other aspects of security also on the platform, which is about, let me just show you before I actually read it. Let's say, I'll just close this one. Now, on platform, other than permission sets, I have few more pages which are not very widely utilized. They are quite underutilized. If you ask me, people do not know about them properly. So I'll just show you those pages. I have user setup. This is a kind of page where you're restricting users to post in a outside a particular date range. Where am I going to use the setup? Obvious question. The answer to that we have external users, right, coming into our platform, maybe auditors. I, as an admin, I do not want to be doing any kind of posting outside the date range that I'm providing over here. But then, do I have to do this kind of setup for each and every user? When people should be allowed to post or not? The answer for that would be no. I do not have to do that because I have something called general ledger setup. Pardon my spelling over here. General ledger setup. Now, this is a page where you're actually going to tell your users, we're actually going to assign a kind of date range over here. This setup works on the organization level, organization-wide level. This date is actually going to be set for all the users when they're allowed to do the posting. But when it comes to particular users, like rare users for which you want to give a different date, you can give over here. Other than user setup, we also have user personalization. Now, user personalization, again, is something which your admin is going to work on. So if you go inside the particular user personalization card, which is again for gym, if you see the profile ID is accountant. I can also restrict this user to work in a particular legal entity. If I go under the company, I have in the dropdown two legal entities over here. I can just switch the legal entity and then it will make gym restricted to that particular legal entity. As an administrator, I can also clear the personalized pages of gym. So personalization is something, it's a process that any user can do on the platform. For example, we can move various options. So let me just show you what. For example, I have this page opened up. I, as a user, I can move these options here and there. That is a kind of personalization I can do on the platform. But as an admin, I can clear the personalization of any user I want. And I can also achieve the same goal through my profiles page. See, this is the profile ID, description, the scope, and also we have here, if I want to make a particular profile ID as a default role center, that anybody who is actually getting into the system, a default role should be assigned to them. So I can make it as a default role. Or I can disable personalization for the entire profile itself. So any person who is having this particular profile ID will not be able to do any personalization. So that is an additional security cover that we have on the platform. Okay. Now, okay, so we have discussed permission sets, we have discussed security. So I would like to now summarize this up. So the first part of our presentation, we talked about Navision, what Navision is, how permissions work on Navision, how I can grant different permissions to users. Then we also studied about what a super user is, how you can assign, why you should assign a super user permission to a particular user and why you should not assign it to every user. That is most important here. How we can edit permission sets. And as an administrator, I also have other setups where I can control how users are actually accessing the system. That is about permissions and security on the broader level, the entire security on Navision. So that is about the webinar from my side. If you guys have any questions regarding any of the topics that we have discussed, feel free to ask in the chat. Is this one of apps for BI? Mark is asking. You mean it's business intelligence app? No, Navision is an ERP platform. You can do business intelligence on that.
Thank you all for being with us in this meeting on Friday. So yes, I've already shared the attendance sheet in the chat box. Kindly check it and fill in the attendance. Also, if you want to join the course regarding the webinar, which is related to webinar, you can mail me your queries on my email address that you want to join the course. If you have any queries regarding the course, here is my email ID. And yes, we can end this session officially here. Thank you, Rashmi. Thank you all.
Thank you, Rupali. Thank you for conducting this. Thank you.
Yeah. Have a great weekend ahead.
You too.